Welcome in the world of artificial intelligence under artificial intelligence using Python series of lectures. This is the lecture on search methods part 4. Hi, I am Dr. Sunil from GCS Solutions. In this lecture, we see Python code of algorithm. That is, first we'll see how to code hill climbing algorithm. Then we'll see the sub algorithms like goal test, move gen and append, and also we see sort and heuristic function, how to code these functions. Before getting into the actual code of the algorithm, let us first see the state space description which is required to be given to the algorithm in form of some data structure. The description of state space is something like this, that A, B, C, D represents the state in the solution space and following moves are legal. For example, one can move from A5 to B3 and C2. Now here, one point to be noted is that the numeric value after a character represents its heuristic value. For example, if I say one can go from node A5 to B3 and C2, that means this A5 represents, in A5, A represents node and 5 is its heuristic value. Similarly, we have B3 to D2 and E3 move. One can move from C2 to F2 and G4. Similarly, from D2 to H1 and I99, from F2 to J99, from G4 to K99 and L3. We have been given a start state as A, and here basically one doesn't need any goal description because our algorithm basically tries to go ahead with the strategy which is the optimization strategy. That strategy perhaps might be a minimization or maximization. So this English like description can be represented in form of tree diagram. That is, this is the state space representation in form of tree with certain branching factor. So here, if you see carefully, that A is the root of the tree. From A, one can go to B and C. From B, one can go to D and E. From C, one can go to F and G. From D, one can go to H and I. From F to J and G to L. And these nodes are again specified with the heuristic value. For example, value phi is given as a heuristic value to A, so heuristic value of B is 3, C is 2. Similarly, we have heuristic of all the nodes, and this state space is basically represented in form of a data structure. That means this state space information is to be provided to our algorithm in form of some data structure. Now, the best data structure for Python is dictionary, and dictionary is nothing but a key value pair wherein key is the node, any node, given node, and the value is the least of the successor of successor for a given node. Here, for example, A is the given node and B and C are the successor. So these successors are basically represented as least of least because each of the successor, like B, has heuristic value 3, C has heuristic value 3, and this B comma 3 and C comma 2 itself is a list, and each of this list element is again put in the list. So here, list of the list representation is used as a value of the key A. Similarly, we have key B with list of successor or child node as D and E. For C, there is F and G. For D, there is H and I. For F, there is J, and for G, K and L. So with this data structure, our algorithm proceeds. Now let us see the sub functions or algorithms used by hill climbing. The functions like goal test, move gen, heuristic function and then append function are basically discussed over here. So first we see move gen function. So move gen function takes any node n and it tries to find the successor of that given node n. So how it works? So it basically takes the given node n and first it searches in the list of successor whether that node exists or not. If it exists, then it retrieves the child of the given node n and store in the list variable succ and returns that. So this is coded in Python, like we have a movegen algorithm with n as the node for which the child nodes are to be generated. Now this new list is the temporary list which acts as a least variable to the successor of the given node n. Now if this given node n is in the list of successor keys, so here succ list is the list of successor, which is the data structure we have provided to the algorithm. So let us see here where I am pointing. So succ list is the list of successor wherein you will find all the nodes and their successors. So here for any given node, for example, if n is say b, node b, so it first searches the key. First key is a, and if our given node n is b, then b is not matching to a, so it next searches the next key, that is b. If b matches to b, then it returns this d and e as the successor, so that d and e is retrieved using this notation, that succ least, that is successor least, and if b is the node, that is key, then this succ least b will return the value of that particular key. For example, if n is b, so it will return d and e, and that is returned to the main algorithm. So this movegen will return this to the main algorithm, calling algorithm. Now sort l will sort the given list in the order, whether it is ascending or descending depending on the requirement. So it sorts the given list with some order using some heuristic function, and this heuristic function can be a complex one or it can be even a value specified directly for a given node. So here for a given list L, so Python sort function is called, which will automatically sort the list, and here one needs to specify that on what key that sorting is to be done, because our list L is nothing but a list of the list. For example, if for a node N A, that is n is equal to A, if the successors are like B and C along with the heuristic value respectively 3 and 2, so this is list of list that is given to the sort algorithm. So sort algorithm will retrieve the key of each item. Now it is done using the anonymous function lambda, which takes the element x and it retrieves x of 1. This means that x of 1 means that if this is the element, just see where I point now, if this is the least element, that is b comma 3, now index 0 element is the node and index 1 element is the key. So it will take this key and then this key, and it will sort this least of the list based on the second value of the least element, that is the heuristic value. So it will now keep C here and B after that. That means it will sort the least of the least elements in ascending order of the heuristic values. So that is done here. It is achieved using just sort function and using this lambda function. So here one needs the skills of coding the things in Python. So for that you need to understand the Python first. Then only you can think of writing code like this. Fine. So next is defining heuristic function. This heuristic function h takes a node and returns its heuristic value. So here it is done using heu function in Python. It returns for a given node index 1 value, because each node is a least element having first as the node name and second value as the heuristic value. So it takes node of 1. That means if just see here where I'm pointing, if b comma 3 is the least, that is node, which is represent as a least, if this is the case, then it returns this 3 using node of 1. Now here append function is very simple. It takes two lists. So let us see here where I'm pointing. It takes two lists and it appends the list and store in the temporary new list variable, which is pointing to list, and that is returned to the main algorithm. Now for complete understanding of this entire hill climbing, algorithm. I suggest you or recommend you to watch video lecture 12 of this series, that is AI using Python series of lectures. Now let us see the actual hill climbing algorithm, which calls the other sub algorithms like MoveGen or sort or heuristic function or something. So for this hill climbing algorithm description, again I recommend you to watch video lecture 12 of this series, so that you will be comfortable, because here my intention is not to explain you the way hill climbing works, rather my intention is to convert the given algorithm in actual Python code. So here def hill climbing is defined here in terms of def, that is the keyword def of the Python hill climbing, and it is provided a start node. Now close is the global data structure used in our actual code, so that is to be updated here. So this closed will maintain the nodes visited till algorithm terminates, and this closed will be used by say calling algorithm if required. Now initially n is given a start node, so that is coded here, that n is equal to start. Then MoveGen function is called, so here is the coding for all this subpart, child equal to MoveGen of n, sort child, so that is represented here, that this child list is a list of the child node of current node n, so that is coded like this. So this child list is sorted using sort function, so sort function is the same function which we have discussed in the earlier slide. Then here a front node from the child list is picked and assigned to the new node, so it is done here. For example, new node equal to child of 0, because child is the list wherein first is the node name and second is the heuristic value of that node. Now here some extra statements. You see that these statements basically help us to print the proper output while executing this algorithm. So there, that's why we try to print here start node, then the sorted child list, just to inspect whether everything is going fine or not. That we'll see in the execution part, actual execution part of this code. Then this while heuristic of new node is less than equal to heuristic of the current node n. So here what we are trying to do, we take the current node n, then generate the child of that node n, sort the child and pick the front node from the child if the front node of the front child node of the given node n has a lesser heuristic, then we will try to step ahead. That is, algorithm tries to step ahead. So basically, if this less than condition is used, then it is for the optimization goal is for minimization. If this sign is greater than, then that goal is for maximization. So here our intention is to make this algorithm work like a minimization goal. So here, if this heuristic of the child node of the current node n is less, then we need to take this new node, that is child node, as the current node, and again generate the child of this current node and sort the child and again pick the new node from the current child, and this way it inspects. So I'll explain this in the execution part, but coding of this is done in very straightaway manner, that this while loop is transferred like this. So here HEU heuristic function, which is defined and coded in the earlier slide, that is called, and here it is checked. Then again some extra print statement to print the essential execution things while executing this while loop by the algorithm. Now here closed is maintained, a list closed is maintained. Now closed list is such a list which will keep track of all the nodes visited till algorithm terminates. Now once we got the new node as the current node, then MoveGen is called for this current node, because new node is a pair of node and its heuristic. So for this new node, that is node n, zeroth element is the node name and index 1 element is the heuristic value. So we are interested in the node name, so that MoveGen will take that node as the current node and will generate the child node and will again update this child, sort the child, then print the child and close, and then tag the first element of this child list and take it or consider it as a new node, and again loop back. So this will keep happening till this condition fails, and this way this heuristic hill climbing algorithm works. Let us now see the execution of this hill climbing algorithm which we have coded in the earlier slide. Now here driver code calls the hill climbing algorithm with start node as the argument to the hill climbing. So this particular program, which I have saved as hillclimbing.py, which is stored in some specific directory of my laptop, I have called this program on the Anaconda prompt by invoking Python editor, and then execution starts. So here the start is A. So here if you see this state space, and with this description given below, which is provided as a Python dictionary to the hill climbing algorithm. So it works something like this. So it starts with A. So here is the A. So this is the current node. Now the MoveGen function generates the child node of current, that is B and C. So this B and C, these children of A will be sorted. Now sorted list will be like this, that is C and B. Let us see here where I point. So here this is the current node and this is the new node. If heuristic of new node is less than current node, then algorithm steps ahead. So it first visits A. It is the goal in this particular execution is to go for the minimization. That is, goal is minimization goal. And then when it comes to C, it will again take this C as the current. So C is the current, that is N, and it generates the child of the current C, that is F and G. So these are sorted. Then it takes this F as the new node and compares the heuristic of current node is, sorry, new node is lesser than the current node, less than or equal to. So as this is true, so it gets into the next part, that is next step. So it takes F. Now F is the current node and children of F, there is only one child, that is J99. So it takes this as a new node and it checks new node has a heuristic smaller than the current, which is F heuristic 2. So this condition fails, so it comes out of the loop, while loop, and algorithm terminates. So here the nodes visited till the terminations are A, then C, then F. So it has followed basically the path, like it is tending towards the minimization goal. So here the basic problem with this approach of hill climbing is that it is blindfold. So it has given us the path which leads to the minimization, that is first the higher heuristic, then next lower, then lower something, but it has stuck into local minima. The better path would have been A5, B3, then D2, and then H1. For better understanding of this hill climbing, again I suggest you to watch video lecture 12 of this series. Hope you understood this. So dear learners, how was the lecture? Please subscribe GCS Solution if you are not yet subscribed. Like the video if you really like it. Share among the friends. Comment for improvements. We are GCS Solutions, making technology easy to learn. Till next lecture, be intelligent.